Android 10 is now official, but it sadly ends the tradition of Google naming Android versions after a dessert. There's no Android quiche or Android quinoa cheesecake this time, but it does come with a host of new features, and let's take a quick look on this Pixel 3 review unit.
Press the bell icon on YouTube and don't miss another update.
So for all the geeks and the nerds, the dark theme is the highlight of Android 10. It finally brings the feature that's been long awaited. We've seen various companies roll out dark themes on their own skins, but Google has finally made dark theme native on Android 10 as well. This is of course lighter on the eyes, especially if you're using the phone late at night, and it's better for your battery life. You can go to settings and turn on dark mode, and it will be applied across several apps like photos, calendar, etc. So Google has added new gesture navigations to Android 10, and these are supposed to be smoother and better than what we had in Android Pie. Now there's a single dedicated button for gesture navigations on Android 10. This is in contrast to what we saw in the previous version where there was a dedicated back button. With the Android 10 gestures, you can just swipe left or right on the edge to go back to a previous app. If you have an app open, you can just swipe down and you'll go back to the home page. And if you have an app open and you want to go, say, to the previous app that you had open, you can just swipe, hold down and keep swiping to get to the previous app. With Android 10, Google is taking privacy a lot more seriously. One major change is around location sharing with apps. You can now control how long and how often you want to share location with an app. There are much more detailed settings like we've seen on iOS, and it's good to see Android catching up on this feature. Android 10 will also give you reminders if an app has been accessing your location for too long. Here, you can again take control and decide if you want to continue sharing your location with the particular app. There's also a new privacy section under the settings. This has all controls around your web activity and ad settings as well, and you can tweak them as needed. Another important change that Google is bringing is how it will push out Android's security updates with Android 10. These will be pushed out now from the Google Play Store itself, just like how any other app is updated on the Play Store. So what this means is that you don't really have to wait for a full OS update in order to get the latest security updates from Google. With Android 10, Smart Reply has actually gotten a lot smarter. Now, if someone messages you, say an address or even a YouTube video, you don't have to copy paste it and then go into Google Maps to open that address or copy paste that link and open that YouTube video. It'll just happen automatically. With digital well-being, Google is adding a new focus mode as well. For those who are not aware, digital well-being was added last year on Android Pie. With focus mode, you'll be able to select some apps as distracting apps, say your email or your news apps, and mark them as silent. And once you're in this focus mode, you will get no alert from these apps and you can focus on whatever you're trying to do. But this feature is right now in beta, and those who are interested will have to sign up for it on the Google website. With Android 10, there's more control over notifications as well. Once you mark a notification as silent, you won't actually get those notifications at all. This is again putting more control in the hands of users. There's also a live caption feature with Android 10, and this will basically add captions to any video, audio, podcast, anything that even you record. And this is coming later in the fall. It's not yet available.